can't believe we're finally safe and together.
Believe it.
Nothing is going to keep us apart.
No more danger. No more fear. Tell me again.
Don't bother, Holly. I'm going to make it up to you for everything you've been through. We're going to start fresh.
A new life. Sounds so wonderful.
Yeah, a new life. That's what I wanted to tell you.
What?
Luke and Laura had a baby boy.
Oh, that is good news. That's fantastic.
Excuse me, Mr. Scorpio. There's a phone call for you.
What?
Who would call you here?
No idea. Scorpio.
Robert, it's Ballantyne. Sorry to bother you on the plane, but it's important.
I see. What is it?
I'm at your office. I'd like you to come here directly from the airport.
Can you tell me why?
I don't want to get into that over the phone, Robert. Can I expect you?
Yeah, I'll be there. Thank you.
Who was it?
It's Ballantyne. He's here in Port Charles. He wants to see me as soon as I get in.
What are you going to tell him?
The whole truth. Sean. Past. Everything. Okay?
You and I love each other, and that is all that matters.
I'm going to hang on to that. We're going to have a new life. Fresh beginning. That's my promise to you.
Tell me some more about Australia.
Oh, right. Well, it's a big flat place. Big flat place.
Yeah.
Not like a stadium, but a big flat place, right? Prairies as far as the eye can see. All these funny little things, woolly things, we call them sheep.
Sheep.
Yeah, they look like little fat clouds. They do little dop around all over the place.
Am I going to like your uncle?
You're going to love him. He's going to be crazy about you.
How long do you think it's going to take you to wrap up everything with Sean's trial?
Well, I'm going to make it all as fast as possible, believe me.
There's so much to do. As soon as we get back, I'll let the city council know that we'll be giving up the house. And it shouldn't take me more than a month or so to pack everything up. That'll give you enough time to sort everything out.
I will take care of all of that. I want you out of Port Charles.
What do you mean, out of Port Charles?
As soon as you can pack your things.
But why?
Look, I just mean I want you out of Port Charles as soon as possible. The press are going to want details of the kidnapping. And then there's going to be this business of Prescott. We never found him. I don't want you around where he can possibly lay his hands on you.
He wouldn't dare come up.
I don't think he would either. But I want you out of the country. I'll feel safer. It's going to take me quite a while to help the DA prepare the case against Sean.
I don't want to go to Australia alone.
Well, go to London first. See if Nanny would like to go with you.
Yeah, well, if Nanny will go with me. How long before you can join me?
I reckon about a month.
A month?
Well, I, at the latest. Come on, darling, what do you say?
Say yes for Robert?
This flight has been full of surprises, I can tell you that.
Listen, by the time I get to Sydney, you'll be a swilling Aussie.
Oh, I hope not. And certainly if Nanny has anything to say about it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're starting our descent into Port Charles. Please make sure your seat belts are fastened and your seats are in an upright position. We'll be landing in about...
Listen, why don't you book your flight to London and Sydney at the airport? And I'll just go straight from there to see Ballantyne in my office.
All right, I'll meet you there later.
This meeting shouldn't take too long.
It had better not. You and I have a date for some serious lovemaking later.
Not even Ballantyne's going to miss that, huh?
You can take the cuffs off. There's no need for that. How are you?
Well, I've had better days.
I think we all have. How are they treating you, Sean?
No complaints.
Anything you need?
Not a thing.
Fine.
finished with him?
I think I have everything I need.
Put him in a cell.
Oh, this is where I lose my watch and my belt, right? Robert, I've told Ballantyne everything, so there's no need for you to repeat it, right? He knows all the facts concerning WSB. I've left nothing out.
Good. Anything you need, just call me.
A little pheasant on the glass, wouldn't it?
Do what I can.
Thanks, Ted.
You bet. Something happened. It was about 7 years ago. Anne and I first became a team for Sean and the WSB.
7 years ago?
Yeah, approximately. We were on assignment together. I failed to give Sean a full report about what happened.
Look, I am not your confessor, Robert. I don't want to hear anything about the past.
It's important. I did something that I'm quite ashamed of.
Now, look, haven't we all done something that we're ashamed of? Any good agent worth his salt has. Now, if this is not directly related to Sean Donnelly and the Aztec treasure, then let it stay in the past where it belongs. Now, is it related?
No, not really, except that I protected an agent.
Now, you don't have to say any more. Now, Robert, when Anna Devane was injured in that explosion, she held the WSB secret code in her hand. The DVX never got a hold of it. We traded a DVX agent, Bronson, for a WSB spy, and the case was officially closed. End of story, Robert.
Right. Well, what are you going to do about Sean?
Well, we'll have to play down his involvement with the Bureau. We'll have to try to disassociate ourselves from him.
Well, does it help his case that he endeavored to contact the Mexican government and return the treasure before I called him?
Might help with the courts, but not with the Bureau.
But the fact that he was prepared to turn the treasure over, I mean, must mean something. Maybe we can get the charge reduced to grand larceny.
Well, that's up to the district attorney and the judge, and you know as well as I do, there's nothing I can do there.
Yeah, understood.
Well, I've got everything I need. I'm heading back to Washington.
If there's anything you need, you know where to find me.
I know that, Robert. You've done a fine job. Believe me, I know how difficult it's been for you. You should be proud.
No, I'm not proud. However, I am appreciative of the help of Anna Devane and two very enthusiastic amateurs, Felicia Cummings and Briscoe Jones. Seeing Ballantyne off. You haven't been waiting long.
No, just a few minutes. I'm all set. I'm booked on a flight to London tomorrow, and then on to Australia next week.
Perfect. Does Nanny know you're coming?
Yes, I called her from the airport. She's ecstatic about going to Australia with me.
You can always count on Nanny.
Robert, what happened with Ballantyne?
Well, his major concern was disassociating himself and the WSB from Sean. Sean, in effect, is being set adrift, so to speak.
Well, you can hardly blame Ballantyne.
No. He's a good man. He's just doing his job.
What about the past, you and Anna?
Ballantyne said the past was dead and buried. Case closed officially.
Oh, Robert. The past dead and buried.
The future's more than a dream now, sweetheart.
I can hardly believe it.
Neither can I.
You know, I'm in the mood for a very nice, quiet, relaxing evening alone with you.
Not too relaxing, I hope.
Well, if you think I mean sleeping, you're very wrong, Mr. Scorpio.
Mrs. Scorpio, I've been waiting all day. Now, this room finally looks right. You're back in.
Have a look at this. Now, you didn't do it. You couldn't possibly have had time.
Even if I'd thought of it.
Welcome home. Thought you might like a little luncheon à deux. You're two of the best. Love, Celia and Jimmy Lee.
I thought of everything.
Even the music. They are so sweet.
What's this? Aha! It's my favorite champers.
Champagne. In the middle of the day. How wonderfully decadent.
As soon as I get the cup off.
I don't trust you with champagne.
That's unfair. That's only because you've seen me uncork bottles before.
That's very true.
And break the top off.
Okay.
Right. Let's get on with the toast.
Good idea.
What do you think? I know. To a future. Now that we have one.
The most perfect.
One more toast.
What better toast could there be than our future?
To Australia.
To Australia.
Down the hatch.
Oh, no.
Yes.
I should get used to this.
Chug along. Rely on Jimmy Lee to lay on a proper supply of champers.
Mm-hmm. One for lunch.
And one for later.
Thank you very much. You know, I have an idea. You've been through a terribly harrowing experience.
So have you.
Well, exactly. So, my idea is that we take this lovely bottle of champagne up to the source.
Oh, what a great idea.
Strictly for therapeutic purposes, of course.
Oh, of course.
Robert.
Isn't this the sauna?
Not yet.
Do we care?
Not me.